Hey friends, welcome back to my channel on Feral's Mad World, and this is Feral. So today I'm at Addis Ababa Museum, and it is the Addis Ababa's most compact museum which has history of Ethiopia. So come, let's go inside. Before we start, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel. Please do it, because as I said, when you like and share and subscribe my channel, it gives me an encouragement. So do it now. So this museum has a very interesting history. I just got to know that this museum was built by the king before, and this place was used as a school, it was used as a restaurant, it was used as a pharmacy and as a t-shirt factory, and then this place is converted into a museum. But this is long time back. So basically in this room, this museum has 6 rooms, and in this room it is the history of the city of Addis Ababa. In this museum, it has history of Addis Ababa, and at this corner, it has the photographs of the mayor of Addis Ababa. He is the first mayor and his name is Zawdi Taklu. He is War Minister Ras Biru Wolde Gabriel, and King Menelik gifted this house to him. His name is Ras Biru Wolde Gabriel. It talks about the year 1888, and he passed away in 1945. This house is converted to museum, and so his photograph is here. As it is mentioned here, this house was built by an Indian named Haji Kawas for Emperor Menelik II. And so this house is used as a residency until 1935, but this museum is very, very old. It is much older than the National Museum. So guys, can you see this pot? This pot has an alcoholic drink which is called Taj, and it is more than 100 years old. And because it is 100 years old, the alcoholic concentration in it has gone very high, and it has been preserved for so many years because it has historical connection. Rase Biru, the war minister, gifted this alcoholic drink to his family member, and this alcoholic drink is called Taj, and that is why it has an historical connection and it has been kept in the museum. These are the glasswares and cutlery which was used by Ras Biru and his family. So as you can see in this, it is the King Menelik II and his wife Empress Taitu. Whenever they had alcohol, they had it in this kind of glasses and glassware. This elegant robe was worn by Lieutenant General and the guard of the gate. This sword and shield was used by Emperor Menelik and his officials during war. So this is the house of King Menelik during that time, and he stayed in this house. This house is at Ontoto, and this house still exists. So now we will be entering the developmental hall, and it shows all about the history. It shows all about the development that happened during the king's time in Ethiopia, in Addis Ababa. So basically this room is all about the first thing that happened in Ethiopia, the first train, the first telephone, the first vehicle, motor vehicle, and so on. And I'll show you. So this is the first motor engine that was in Addis Ababa at Lagar. And this is how the railway station looked. It is still there, but now no one uses it. This is how the railway track looks. This is the first automobile. So guys, this is the first telephone that came to Ethiopia in 1890, and Ras Makonnen got it from Italy during that year. And the technology was so new that when they wanted to communicate, they said hello, they had to wait for 30 minutes for the response to get from the other side. And nowadays we are just misusing the technology, but when I heard the story of this telephone, it made me laugh that they had to wait for 30 minutes to just get a response of saying hello. So imagine the communication they had during those time. It was a quick communication. So in this picture, it is the mayor of the city communicating on telephone. I don't think during those time they would be saying hello, they would be just saying their message. I have this work, please get it done for me, and it's done. Who would wait for 30 minutes long to just get their message communicated? So guys, this is very interesting. This is a picture which shows it's the first salon in Ethiopia in 1900. Now there was no electricity. So as you can see, he is pumping by his leg for the electricity, and then the streamer works. It's exciting. And this is the time of 1900, during the King Menelik's time. And so that is why Menelik's time is considered to be a good time, because there were too many things which were brought to Ethiopia. As you can see in this picture, there are different musical instruments that were brought from outside countries, and the musicians were trained. Good. So this is the first hotel in Ethiopia, and it is Hotel Taitu, as you can see. And now this is the first cinema, Empire Cinema, which is in Piazza during Menelik's time. This is the first cafe, Winer's Cafe. This is in Arada, Piazza. So this is the Zahn Pharmacy. The owner of this pharmacy was from Germany, and Zahn means teeth, and so it is called Zahn Pharmacy. But now the Zahn Pharmacy is called the Lion Pharmacy, which is the oldest pharmacy of Ethiopia. It's the first pharmacy of Ethiopia. And then this is how it looks. The people come to take medicine on their horses. And this is the first postal office, which is in Piazza. And this is how the letters and other things are done, the process. And this is the postman who goes from city to city to give the post. And so this is the first Ethiopian Airlines during Menelik's time, and this is how the passengers are waiting for the flight. And wow, there was no immigration, no boarding, nothing. This is amazing. So now we have finished with the room, which is invention, and now we are in this Adwa room. Adwa is the name of a place, and also when Ethiopians and Italians fought, it is called Adwa. The word Adwa is used. And so this room is basically on all the things that were during the Adwa time and things that were used in the war. So this is the time when Italians invaded Ethiopia twice. Once when it was Menelik time, and the second during the King Haile Selassie's time. So during Menelik's time, they did not have any modern weapons, equipments. The roads were not developed. So these people walked for 5 months to go to the Adwa, which was the war place. And after 5 months, when they reached to that place, they fought with Italians and they won. So they walked for 5 months, and the war just took 1 day, and they won the battle, because Ethiopians, there were many soldiers. Italians, the people were less. And this is the place which shows that how they carried their food, their water, their alcoholic drink. So this is the bag which they carried their water. This is their food bag. And this is a trunk-like thing which carried the alcoholic drink called Tach. And these are the other instruments which they used for the war. So basically in this war, men and women went together. Women helped the men by cooking the food. And men fought the war. As I said, the war lasted only for 1 day, but they walked for 5 months to reach to Adwa. And so this is the history of the victory of Adwa. So basically this is a very beautiful picture painted by an artist, which shows the victory of Adwa, which shows that how the war was done. And basically it shows that these are the Italian soldiers. They are less. They had all the modern weapons, equipments and other things. While on the other hand, these are the Ethiopian people, which they did not have any modern weapon. They used sword and other things in the war. And the history is that Ethiopians won and Italians were never able to colonize the country. So now we are in this room, which is called the Diplomacy and Fascist Room. As I said, that the Italians invaded Ethiopia twice, and the second time they came during the King Haile Selassie's time. King Haile Selassie ruled the country for almost 44 years, and when the Italians invaded the country for the second time, they fought for 5 years. And I'll show you the room. So basically, they are the generals of Ardwa during the king's time. These are the imported rifles brought during King Haile Selassie's time, and the soldier used this during the war. Now this rifle was able to release only one bullet at a time, and it had to be manually reloaded. So basically, these are the kinds of medals that were given to the military services after the victory of Ardwa. This stone-like thing is the first Ethiopian currency, which was used during the barter system. And it is so nice to see that how the currency evolved throughout the years, from the pennies to the currency. So basically, during King Haile Selassie's time, the currency changed 4 times. It was demonetized 4 times. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this currency was changed during the Dirk's time. After this currency, twice the currency has been changed, which they have not kept in the museum yet. But it is so nice to see Ethiopia's history. This is the Africa Union Hall, which was built during King Haile Selassie's time. And this is the new constructed Africa Union Hotel in 2019. This one. And King Haile Selassie is considered to be a very powerful king, and he brought lots of good development during his time. So basically, this is the hall, which is called Century Mall. And in this hall, there are different paintings from different artists, from different people, from different countries. They have given gift to the country, given gift to this museum. And so it is called Century Hall. So as I said, different artists have given gifts, and this is how it looks. Hadassah Gizau gifted this piece of art to museum, and it is titled as African Hero to symbolize Ethiopia, which has never been colonized. And this art piece has arrow and a shield. So basically, this is the connecting room, which has all the mayors of Addis Ababa. There are total in all 33 mayors in Addis, but this wall shows just 29 mayors, and this is how it looks. And this is Mayor's official robe. So this is the elephant tusk given by Ethiopian Workers Association to the museum. Different countries gifted this museum different things, and so it has been displayed here.